you doing, you old pirate? So good to see you. Hey, welcome back to another video. We are talking about one of my favorites today, Darth Maul. Maul was a force-sensitive Dathomirian Zabrak Neil and Dark Side warrior who served as the apprentice Dark Lord of the Sith, Darth Maul, to Darth Sidious. The son of Mother Talzin of the Night Sisters, he was taken at a young age, and through his training, Maul grew strong in the Force, becoming an expert lightsaber duelist. During the crisis on Naboo in 32 BBY, Maul confronted Jedi Master Qui-Gon Jinn and Padawan Obi-Wan Kenobi. Let's delve into these interesting facts about Darth Maul. Number 8. His story continues. We were introduced to Darth Maul in Star Wars Episode 1, The Phantom Menace. During the Duel of Fates on Naboo, Maul impales Qui-Gon Jinn and soon after is cut in half by the Avenger Obi-Wan Kenobi. The Jedi believe Maul to be dead, however we learn in the EU and the Clone Wars animated TV show that he did in fact survive, only surviving through his obsessive hatred of Obi-Wan, clinging onto life to seek revenge for being defeated. He lived in exile on the Outer Rim, moving around on his new cybernetic legs. As part of Maul's revenge plan for Obi-Wan, he joined forces with his long-lost brother, Savage Opress. Savage played a key role in Maul's survival after he was cut in two on Naboo. He brought Maul to Mother Talzin and helped train Maul to get back to where he was. The two brothers recruited a highly skilled group of assassins and criminals named the Shadow Collective to help their plan. After his defeat by Obi-Wan, in the Clone Wars TV show, it is revealed that he spent the first 10 years on the junkyard planet of Lotho Minor. Savage Opress rescued Maul and brought him to his mother, the Dothmerian witch Mother Talzin. Talzin used her magic to rebuild Maul's muscles and bring back his former mental state. Up until this point, he was a crazed shell of his former self. As part of the Zabrak species, which may have humanoid features, however is inherently different, one of the most obvious differences is the horns that the Zabraks have atop their heads. However, there is a unique feature that only a very few species have. Zabraks possess two hearts. They work like human kidneys, so if one stops working, the other would keep pumping blood in its place, practically giving them an extra life. Maul was an excellent duelist. He devoted much of his time and energy practicing and perfecting his fighting style, which was the seventh of seven styles forbidden for Jedi to use, as it was the hardest and most aggressive style one could use. Having mastered both dual and single blades, the style relied heavily on acrobatics, stamina, and physical strength. As a Juyo practitioner, he was filled with both fury and malignant grace. Before we get into our top three facts about Darth Maul, I'd like to say, if you're like me and think about Star Wars every day, you can find me on Instagram and Facebook at Star Wars Oosh for daily Star Wars content. One small detail about Darth Maul that is easily overlooked is that he has a small earring on his left ear. On the upper part of his left ear is a small pearl-like earring that ever so slightly adds to the menacing nature of Maul. This earring is down to a costuming error on the set of The Phantom Menace. After being fully costumed and having all of his makeup put on, Darth Maul's actor, Ray Park, realized that he had forgotten to take out this earring. George Lucas thought it added a nice touch to Maul's character and decided to leave it in. The Zabrak species is entirely carnivorous. As opposed to omnivores, Darth Maul's species will only eat meat. No vegetables or plants are included. The Dothmarian tribe that Maul came from holds a lot of honor in strength and violence. I guess this restrictive diet can explain part of Maul's drive and raw aggression. In the Son of Dathomir comics, Maul and a team of Mandalorian criminals capture Count Dooku and General Grievous without much effort. Once he has them, he parades his success in front of Darth Sidious. He does so that Sidious can see their failure. Even though Maul hates Sidious and seeks revenge, he also seeks approval, which makes their relationship even more complicated. If you enjoyed my video and want to see more of them, please be my guest and hit the subscribe button below. And while you're there, hit the notifications bell to get notified when my videos get released. That's all from me. Take care and may the Force be with you.
Do what must be done. Do not hesitate. Show no mercy.